What's going on, everybody? This is your man's Minister TJ. Now I'm so excited to be with you another Sunday. Let's go. Listen, I need you all gonna go ahead and come on in and make sure you share the broadcast. Make sure you comment. It's a day that the Lord has made, and we shall rejoice and be glad in it. Listen, let's get it. Listen, I'm so excited that you're joining me on today. Listen, it's Sunday. You made it another week. The devil tried to stop you. He tried to, you know, put all these obstacles in front of you, try to attack your mind. But guess what? You're more than a conqueror. You're more than a conqueror. So I want you to know that God loves you. Matter of fact, say that to yourself. Say, God loves me. Come on. Y'all share this broadcast. I got an awesome guest with me on today. It's going to be so awesome. You want to tune in. I've been punching in the clock, trying to keep the kitchen stock. Man, it's a blessing because we ain't never had a lot. But all we need is all we got. Come on, y'all. Y'all share this broadcast. Start that watch party. Matter of fact, tag somebody. Come on, say something to me in the comments. We want to get this party started. Baby, I'm too busy counting all these blessings. Listen, I want you to join me on next Sunday. I will be celebrating my 1-year anniversary doing Unfiltered Conversations. Make sure you join me. And it's going to be my birthday, y'all. So make sure you holler at your boy. Come on. Come on. How many people know that this is the year of manifestation? Matter of fact, do you know the definition of manifestation or manifest? The definition of manifest is to be clear and obvious to the eye and mind. So God is about to do some awesome things. It's going to be clear and obvious that he's with you. Amen. That he's Emmanuel, God with you. So matter of fact, I want you to praise him in advance. Celebrate God right now before the manifestation happens. Come on. Come on. Count your blessings up. Come on. Big shout out to my lovely wife. She's the new author of the book, My Melon is Popping on My Beautiful Brown Skin. Make sure you holler, go ahead and purchase it. Go to Amazon.com to get your copy. I'm telling you, it'll bless your life. Blessings falling in line. Yes, I need a taper. And every loss is a lesson. Tell my haters I confess. Treat them like a dream. Make sure you tag somebody. Let them know that we on. Come on. I won't ever think I'm better than the next man. I hope and pray that, you know, God bless you if you is in service in person. If you watch it online, I pray that God change and transform your life in some capacity, in some type of way. God move in your life. So you got to praise God. Hallelujah, hallelujah. So listen, I'm so excited that you're with me on today. Like I said, you have to praise God in season and out of season, no matter what's going on. Man, it's so important to praise him in the midst, even in the midst of the storm, even when things are good or if things are challenging. Praise him. Matter of fact, come on, just lift your hands and praise God and surrender to him and just thank him for what he's already done and what he's about to do. Come on, somebody put that in the comments. What he's about to do. Hallelujah. So if you can do me a favor, come with me and pray and let's touch and agree. Even though we're virtual, let's touch and agree in the spirit. Father, I thank you, God, for this time. I thank you for this awesome, awesome show that you've already blessed, that you've already gone in the spirit and show me in the spirit that you're going to move miraculously upon this show. You're going to touch people's hearts. And I'm calling forth young people as they go, as they prepare to go back to school, as they prepare to, you know, for their the next year, if they're a junior, if they're a senior, even if they're a freshman, even if they're in middle school or elementary school, I pray, God, that you bless the parents and bless the students and bless the teacher as well. Let the anointing of God be upon them, Lord God. Lord God, let them have high expectations as they go back to school. Don't let just the teachers have high expectations, but let the children, the students have high expectations of themselves. Let them make straight A's, God. Let them go in this school year with confidence, with wisdom, with a boldness like never before. I pray that you will bless them and cover them as well with your precious blood. And I rebuke the coronavirus. I pray, Lord God, that the teachers and the students and everybody that's in the building will stay safe. And I know, Lord God, that they are covered upon the blood of Jesus. And we give you the glory, honor, and the praise in Jesus' name that we pray. Somebody say amen. Come on. Shout amen. Put it in the comments. Shout amen. So I'm so excited to be with you on today. Again, we are elated that God has brought us this far. Like I said, we're about to celebrate our 1 year anniversary next year. I cannot even believe that I've been doing this for a whole year. And I told God, God, this is your platform. This is your show. And I'm telling you, God has been so faithful to his word. He's been so faithful in providing the different guests and in which he told me to do a year ago. So I'm telling you, I'm so excited. And I'm also have great expectation for what he's going to do next. Amen. So I want you to join me next week as we celebrate our 1 year anniversary, and I'm going to be celebrating my birthday. So make sure you tune in, even if it's for a moment, tune in with me so we can celebrate God and praise God for what he has done. Amen. All right. So my guest today is no stranger to me, man. I love this young man, and God put it on my heart for these months or these shows coming up for my 1 year anniversary to be about young people. You know, God put young people in my heart, and God has blessed me to find young people. You know, young people are busy. They got a lot going on, but God has blessed me to find young people who have great credibility, who love God, who's doing great things in that community, in our schools, and within our family. And I'm so grateful that, you know, God blessed me with a nephew years ago. Amen. And I've seen this young man grow up. I've seen him do some great things, man. And he's just so mature now. He's in this upcoming Arise of Senior year. And I'm so excited that he's with me on today. So everybody, put your virtual hands together for my nephew, none other than Corey C.J. Mosley. What's up, fam?
What's up? How y'all doing?
So, y'all, this is my nephew, man. Listen, I know a lot of people say we favor each other just a tad bit, but this is my nephew. Now he's sporting the dreads now, so big shout out to his mom, and who is my sister Sonia, and his sister Desiree. I think she recently locked his hair and so forth. So I'm just so grateful that he's with me on today, because God is doing amazing things in his life. And I'm so grateful that he's on a path, man, to do some great things. And like I said, big shout out real quick to my sister who's helped him get on this path, who's really been pushing him and encouraging him and loving him and creating opportunities for him to do a lot of great things. So, yeah, big shout out to Sonia Lee. That's my older sister. So, CJ, what's up, man? How you doing?
Doing good. How you doing?
I'm doing awesome, man. I'm doing awesome. So, I want you to tell me a little bit about yourself so everybody can know who you are, like what school you go to, what sports you play, you know, where you see yourself in the next 5-10 years, what you want to do for your future, etc.
Hi, how y'all doing? I'm CJ. I'm class of 2022. I play football and basketball for, you know, Highland Springs High School. And next 5-10 years, I see myself being successful and playing college football, most likely, and playing the NFL in the next level after college football. because I'm trying to graduate with a degree after college. But
that's what I'm talking about. Make sure you get that degree. Hallelujah. That's right. Tell me a little bit about your family. You, of course, you have your mom. Tell me about a little about who you are and your family and so forth.
You know, this is my uncle, of course, y'all see on here. Y'all might think we got a lot in common, but we kind of do, you know, kind of same height and stuff. My mom is his sister. I have another aunt, my aunt Nicole. Then I have a grandma, which is his mother. Best grandma we could ever ask for. And then I'm blessed to have, like, the immediate family I have myself. Like, it's just a blessing. And my papa, Gary, they all support me. My whole immediate family support me to the fullest. And that's what anyone my age could even ask for. Because I know some who even old parents don't support. And that's the total opposite from my own mother.
Praise God. And, of course, did you say Desiree? I don't know if you said Desiree.
Oh, yeah, Desiree is well, my older sister.
Yeah. And she down at Virginia State doing her thing, you know, in the band and so forth. So, listen, I've been watching you, man. We all been watching. This summer has been literally a major shift in your life, I believe. I mean, I remember sitting down with you before the summer started. But I didn't know, man, it was going to be like this. Did you know it was going to be like this?
No, I had no idea it was going to be like this. It's like opportunity and opportunity stacked on top of each other over and over again.
I'm telling you. And I was, you know, talking to your mom, and she was telling me that this summer had to be like this because of the fact that, you know, you've been playing behind other star players who were seniors who need to get, you know, full rise in school. So you've been playing behind them within the last 3 years. Matter of fact, you didn't start playing football to win.
Ninth grade. I mean, a drastic change to this.
I remember he was playing baseball. He started out with baseball. So, and I thought he was going to be a great baseball player. Then he shifted and started playing basketball. I said, okay. But then he shifted again and started playing football. One thing about CJ, whatever he put his mind to, whatever he say he's going to do, that's what he's going to do. And he's going to put his all in it. I mean, he really going to push until he see the manifestations in his life. So I'm so happy for you and proud of you, man, because you've been pushing. You've been working hard. Matter of fact, you in your own personal weight room with the big CJ on your wall. This is where you get it in. Show me them guns real quick. Show me them guns.
I got a little something arsenal.
Like I told him before the show started, I said, man, you can't be in the weight room, don't have no guns, man. You know, listen, he got his own personal weight room. And thank God, you know, that his mom, God has blessed his mom to provide this weight room in his house so he can just get up and work out. He'll have no excuse not to be, you know, strong and built, you know, he got it right downstairs. So, all right. So again, you know, you've been to all these different camps this summer. You know, this has been a major shift, and I've seen you in different states. I think you went to 20 camps in 8 different states, man. I mean, it seemed like you just been on a whirlwind on the road, man, and you've been meeting so many different people. Tell me something. I really want to know how important is it for you to have good character? You experiencing this all summer. Are the colleges just looking for just the football player?
No, not at all. Actually, they're looking at character first, then football. Because wow. If you're a great football player and you can't don't have any good character at all, how can they use you on their team? They can't. And grades also is for character as well. They look at grades and character, then football. To be honest with you, football is the last thing to look at, especially they recruiting you before you even go to the camp. Like some of these colleges been doing, they invite me to camp. They would recruit me before. They were looking at the character and they wanted to see the character at the camp. They were looking at the grades first before they even invite me.
Wow, that's and I don't think a lot of people know that. That's
They just think because they have a great son that's good at football, they can just take him places and he can get these offers and stuff. But you have to have great grades and character before they even look at it. Some people are terrible teammates. And that's why the people who are terrible teammates are not getting the results they have now. Because coaches ask, college coaches, they ask the high school coaches, how is he a teammate? How is he a player? Like, how is he? Before they even try to, they want to get a whole relationship with you, especially if you're an older guy like me. If you're an underclassman, they might just offer you and just keep it moving, or they just gonna keep in touch with you after that. If you're like me and you're getting closer to the time where it's time to commit, they want to know basically everything. And especially if you went to college, they're going to know everything about you. It's not one thing they're not going to know about you.
Wow. That's major, man. That's major. What I want to do, first, let me ask you this question before I go into this next phase. Tell me some of the challenges that you had to go through growing up as far as, you know, on the field, off the field, that has helped you to build up your confidence and even getting closer to God in this phase of your life right now. What's some of the challenges that you had to go through where you needed God's help and so forth, and you still need God's help? So tell me some things about that.
I'm gonna keep it real. The reason, like, you know, God's help, like, before I even started playing football, I did one thing, it's one word, pray. Almost every day, I try to, but every day I do one word, pray. Prayer will get you where you want to go, because it's just like what, if you're trying to earn a spot on a football team, if you're working hard, they're gonna give you that spot. They're not gonna give it to you, earn that spot. If you pray, if you just pray and just sit in the house and don't put any effort or work to it, it's not gonna happen. If you pray, if you pray and you show God and you want it as much, because the eye of the sky don't lie. If you're showing God that you want it as bad as you say you are in your prayer, it's gonna come to life. And that's exactly what it's been doing.
Wow. 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 So, you know, I know it was humbling, man, for you have to be behind certain players and you had to be patient. You know, of course, listen, for everybody who don't know, who don't live around the city of Richmond area, Holland Springs High School has one of the best, has the best, let me say it like that, program in the state. I mean, they hands down have the best program. They've won multiple championships within the last 5 to 7 years. I mean, some back to back. How many championships have y'all won?
We won 4 straight, like 6 or 8 total, 6 or 7 total. 4 straight the last 6 years. And another thing, hit back on the top before, when I started my 9th grade year, you know, just like a lot, it's not an excuse, but a lot of people sometimes have this, what I went through. You know, you go through drastic, well, not drastic change, but I went on my grades like I was supposed to. I went from a 1.9 GPA in 9th grade. I had a 1.9 GPA. And now my junior year, I had a 4.17 GPA. So.
Hold on.
Yes. You heard right.
When did you have a 1.9 GPA?
9th grade. My 9th grade year. After 9th grade year, that was my GPA for that year. And I had to go to summer school. I couldn't even play my 10th grade year.
So, man.
I was in jeopardy of not playing my 10th grade year. I ended up playing, but I was in jeopardy. I had to go to summer school just so I could play to get an extra point up, to get a 2.0 just to meet the team's requirement. Yes.
You know, that's something that I didn't know. So that this is why this topic today, Destined for Greatness, because the Bible said, greater is he that's in you than he that's in the world. So greatness is when you have God, when you accept Jesus Christ as your personal savior, and he's the Lord of your life, right? You have greatness on the inside of you already, just like that. But it takes you to tap into it. And I'm gonna be honest with you. Last year, I seen you go to a place that I never seen you go before. Every time I talk to your mom, every time I talk to you, man, you was, you know, I think the pandemic actually helped you in a sense of as far as not being distracted at school, because you had to do virtual. So for him, he really grinded it out at home, and that's when his GPA really jumped up. Because I think you made straight A's last year. Was it straight A's?
Straight A. And it's like some people, it was actually hard for them to be virtual, but for me it wasn't, because now you have, like, you know, really real distractions for real. You can actually do your work and sit down and do your own work.
Yeah, man. And so greatness, I want everybody to hear this, and I want you to pull in your young people that's in your house right now, and I want you to hear his testimony. He had a 1.9 GPA his freshman year.
That was not who I was supposed to do. Hang around the wrong people. From the people from middle school, I was hanging around the wrong people. Not focused on what I'm going to do. Not separating myself. Like, when you can tear around the building, people who carry themselves well, those are people who are great. The people who carry themselves well, I was not carrying myself well. I was doing some bad things.
And see,
it was hard to balance for my first year even playing football. It was hard to balance that. But I am basketball, but I overcame it because I worked hard at it. I had a task at hand, and I drove to Destined to be is great. And I'm not done yet either.
Oh, you just beginning, man. You just getting started.
Yeah, I'm literally just beginning. Like, seriously. I'm literally just beginning.
I love it, man. This is my nephew, y'all. This is my nephew talking like this. This is what I'm talking about, man. You got me pumped over here. Listen, so did you hear what he said, man? He's driving to be great, man. He's destined to be great because he recognized what's on the inside of him. As at one place, at one moment, at one place in his life, you know, he didn't know who he was. He was hanging around the wrong people, listening to the wrong conversations, being involved in the wrong conversations, doing the wrong things. But he recognized, man, I got greatness on the inside of me. And guess what? I'm being held back. I'm holding my own self back. I'm not doing what I'm supposed to do.
Overcome. Like, overcome is the word. From ninth grade, ever since ninth grade, I had either honor roll or straight A's for every quarter. Like, overcame.
That's what I'm talking about, man. This is even a better year. This is going to be even a better year. Yes. You know,
like, don't list people who criticize. This is another thing about Chris. This next topic, I'm gonna switch the topic. Criticism. I'm gonna switch it to criticism. People can criticize as much as they want, but the ones who criticize you the most, take a look at what they're doing. Most of the time, they're not the ones trying to help you or even help themselves.
Woo.
It's a difference between constructive criticism and just criticism. Constructive criticism, it all is about considering the source. If they're trying to help, actually genuinely trying to help you, you will tell. If you're in my age, like you're in high school, you will be able to tell if someone's trying to help you or someone's not. If not, if you can't tell, then it's an issue. You have to do better. But criticism, I didn't overcame it all, like, as much as possible.
And he's pushing forward. All right, let's switch that real quick.
You have to have a parent that's going to hold you accountable as well. Some of my parents will hold me accountable. This is what I said I wanted, so my mother was holding me accountable. She pushed me to literally no limit. And some people, if this is really what you want, the parent doesn't even have to do that. She even had to do that for real. It is maybe even better.
And my sister's definitely going to hold you accountable. Definitely.
Yeah.
All right. But like you said, but some people can't handle that. Some people can't, and it depends on your mindset. I'm gonna tell you, you can't be great if you can't be held accountable in a great way. I'm telling you, you don't want greatness. You want somebody to pacify you. You want somebody to rub your back and stroke your ego. But if you really want to be great, that's why you see some of the greatest NFL players and coaches, teams. Because there's a high level of accountability, and that's the key. But you have to be able to take it. So stop crying because that teacher is getting after you. Stop crying because your parents are getting after you, you know, and so forth. And you getting mad every time they correct you and things of that nature. Listen, the Bible even say God chastises you because he loves you. He loves you. That's the only reason. But like CJ said, you got to feel that genuine love. Sometimes people do it with a different purpose, right? Sometimes people, you know, have a different reason to do certain things. But you, as long as that person is pushing you in the right direction, that is the key. All right, so let me show everybody some of the things that you have done, CJ, over the course of this past summer. I just want to show people the things that you've done this past summer, some of the camps that you went to and so forth. So bear with me one moment. So we're gonna run through the screen real quick. So, oh, everybody, yesterday he took his, was it the other day he took his senior pictures? Can you see that, CJ?
Yeah. Yeah, so he's talking about seeing pictures. Real emotional, man. Don't believe it.
You must say real emotional. Where were you? This is Fairmont State.
Fairmont State. Yes, sir.
So, guys, he went to 20 different camps.
And that right there is a West Virginia visit.
That's my favorite. That's my favorite picture right there.
Yeah, best visit I've been on so far.
Say that again.
Best visit I've been on so far.
Okay. Man, I love that picture right there.
Yes.
You look good. Look. I ain't saying nothing, but you look good in that uniform, brother. You look good in that uniform.
Yeah, man.
Like that white. A lot of food on the trip. On the trips. He had a lot of food. A lot of different food. University of Delaware.
Delaware camp.
Food again.
Yeah.
James Madison, JMU. That's where my pastor went. Bishop Dane Robinson Jr. He went to JMU.
JMU camp, yep.
And my assistant pastor. Campbell University.
Yes, sir. Campbell University visit. That was another great visit as well.
So I just want to show y'all again. That's again Campbell. Food.
Yeah.
How to eat. Everett University. So guys, I just want to show you. Listen, he literally has been about his business, y'all. He's been about his business. I'm telling you, and I'm so proud of. He's destined for greatness. And if you want to have any takeaway from this episode on today, you got to recognize the greatness that's already in you, and you have to tap into that. I'm gonna say that again.
Yes.
Say
it again. Repeat it louder.
Yeah. If you want to be great, you have to recognize the greatness that's already on the inside of you, and you have to tap into it. And a lot of times, sometimes you think you're too spiritual, you know, to the point where it's great to be spiritual, but sometimes people think they don't have to do any work, because the Bible says faith without works is dead. So just because Jesus Christ is on the inside of you, because you've accepted him into your heart, and you've confessed with your mouth, you still have to manifest. Matter of fact, God says you manifest. He told the disciples, Jesus, when it was two fish and five loaves of bread, and the people was there and they was hungry, and Jesus wanted to teach them, he told the disciples, you feed them. He told them, you feed them, you know, and so forth. And they had to find what was going to feed them, which was two fish and five loaves of bread, what was the little boy's lunch. So you got to understand, God is expecting you. He's already on the inside of you. But for you to be destined for greatness, you have to follow the path of greatness. You have to put in the work. Listen, them muscles not going to get on your arm just to, you know, they not going to just supernatural just get on your arm. He got to go downstairs. He has to, that bench that he's sitting on right now, he got to get up under that bench. And he have to work and build his muscles.
I didn't build my weight too, because I didn't went from 220 before quarantine started to 270.
Say that again.
I didn't went from 220 before quarantine started to 270, and I'm still gaining weight, and I lost some weight as well.
See,
and I play hula as well, so I have to get to like 300 pounds probably before college.
So he had to be on a regimen, and to make sure that he's following the path that. That's set up for him. And his mom, I'm telling you, she's been on it. She wanted, because it's awesome to have a parent that recognize, here it is, parents that recognize the greatness on the inside of you and push you to your maximum potential so you can tap into that greatness. Sometimes as parents, that's how we get frustrated. That's why we get frustrated sometimes, because we recognize the greatness on the inside of you. But you have to put in the work. The greatness is not just going to fall in your lap. You know, the manifestation is not going to just fall in your lap. You have to You have to go out and do the work. You have to go out and do what you need to do. Because my saying is this: you do the possible, God will do the impossible. You go as far as you can doing things that the Lord told you to do, and then God is going to supernaturally do some impossible things in your life. Amen. So, CJ, man, I'm so grateful that you're with me, man. Thank you so much for being on the show. Listen, I'm going to try to, real quick, I forgot to show this. I'm going to show you a quick video, guys. So, video that where CJ was actually, I don't know. Probably have to show an older one. I don't see the new one. All right.
She texted to you.
That's all right. We'll just show this one. All right, everybody. So as you can see, I'm gonna see if I can find this new one. I see it. All right.
See me play. I'm the starting right tackle of Highland Springs. You want to come see me play?
Yes, sir. So he had to switch positions. So he's went from was the right defensive end?
Yeah.
To now you're the right tackle?
Yes, sir.
Offensive tackle. So, this summer has been a lot about educating himself, being educated about his new position, practicing and, testing his skills out, learning new skills, learning new techniques and so forth. So we're going to watch a quick video of his journey for this summer. The summer not over yet, this summer. All right. So everybody, listen. I want you to really
try to get maximum exposure. So that's why I go to these camps because I have as much film without scenes.
I want you to keep my nephew in prayer. Like he said, he plays for Holly Springs High School. He's been putting in the work. He went, like you said, he just went to all these camps because he needed more exposure. And I really believe God has stamped his name in a lot of these coaches' hearts, the recruiters and things of that nature, so he can go to the school that God wants him to go to. So keep him in prayer. If you want to follow him on social media so you can look at more of his journey, make sure you follow him. Here we go. On Facebook at CJ Mosley or on IG at Big CJ Mosley. So make sure you follow him. Man, you're getting a lot of attention on Instagram, you know, on your IG page. Just, you know, getting a lot of views, a lot of likes. So make sure you subscribe or like and befriend him on these different platforms so you can let him know that you're supporting him. Man, I just know that we're really proud of him, excited for what God is doing in his life. All right. So, CJ, is there anything else you want to say?
No, thank you so much for having me on this show.
Oh, man. It's been an honor. It's been my honor to have you on here, man. And listen, this guy's a talker too, so he's gonna have his own show. Trust me. Follow him on his social media. I'm telling you, wherever God take him, he's gonna be talking. If you ask him about statistics and different players, basketball and football, he can tell you. He study and research. He's somebody who he really studies the game. He's not somebody just playing. He studies the game. And he perfect his craft. So that's why God is going to entrust him to go further. So I love you, man. So look, real quick before we log off, I want everybody to make sure they follow me on Facebook and IG as well and YouTube. Go to my Facebook at Minister TJ Woods. Follow me on IG T_J_Woods and subscribe to my YouTube channel at TJ Woods. If you're watching me right now on YouTube, go ahead and subscribe to my channel while you're right there. Go ahead and subscribe to my channel. All right. Also, we want to encourage you to become our partner. All right. We're about to celebrate our 1 year anniversary. My goal is to get 100 partners. And right now we have three. We just started offering people to become partners. We have three partners right now. I'm grateful, you know, for those partners because the Bible says don't despise small beginnings. So I'm grateful for what God has us right now. We believe in God for 100 partners, the partners that's going to pray for us, donate and share information that we're putting out to social media. So if you believe in what we've been doing for the past year, go ahead and even in the comments right now, say, I want to be a partner. Put it right there in the comment section, in the chat. We're going to reach out to you and send you the information that you need. Go ahead, put it in the comments that you want to be a partner. And again, you're going to pray. We ask you to pray. We're going to ask you to encourage you to donate. And there's a commitment of donating 5, 10, however much you can budget for, or you know, say that I can commit to this level of donation each month. And then we ask that you share the information that we're putting out on a monthly basis, especially when we go live, especially when we have Unfiltered Conversations up under TJ Woods Ministries and so forth. So if you give more than $30 a day, even if you're not a partner and you just say, I want to sow a seed, or if you want to become a partner, you want to sow a seed, if you give over $30, we're going to send you a gift. And the gift for this month and pretty much been every month is my wife's book, My Melanin is Popping on My Beautiful Brown Skin. We're going to send that to you in the mail. We're going to send it directly to you. So again, but we're going to need make sure that we reach out to you. So put in the chat, I want to be a partner. And guess what? Even if you don't can't sow a seed on today and you want to be a partner, put that in the comments. Hey, I want to be a partner. You don't have to sow today. So again, if you give more than $30 today, we're going to send you the book. You don't have to be a partner to do this. If you just want to sow a seed of any amount, you can do that on today. How do you sow a seed? You can do it via Cash App, the $TWoods, the number 4JC. And we're going to send you information. So just put that in the chat that you want to be a partner. All right. Also, we're believing God for these 100 partners because we're believing that everything that's on our life, the things that God has been doing for us, is going to be released on your life. And I don't know if you know about the testimony of how God supernaturally paid our house off, which cost over $150,000. Supernaturally, God took us from a 30-year mortgage to a 30-second conversation. And it's only because we've just been flowing with God for many years. And we believe that the prosperity of the Lord is upon our life. And God has anointed us with prosperity. So we believe that as you sow, it's going to be released on your life. We're expecting manifestations to happen in your life as you sow. Because we're believing again, and we're declaring that this is the year of manifestations. And the year's not over yet. All right. The year's not over yet. It's a lot of time for God to continue to manifest in your life. All right. So make sure you join us next week. Again, make sure you join us. We're going to be live here celebrating our 1 year anniversary and my birthday celebration. Join us next week. Don't miss it. Make sure you put it on your schedule. Even if you get only can join us, you know, for a short period of time, I'm going to be bringing different people on the show as we celebrate 1 year of Unfiltered Conversations with your man's Minister TJ. I'm so excited what God is doing. This is, I've been decreeing and declaring that Unfiltered Conversations is where the supernatural happens in the midst of a conversation. Hey, nephew, I love you, man. And we pray, man, and keep on pushing. We're going to be watching at Holland Springs this year football team as y'all go to the top again. All right. God bless y'all. See y'all next week.
Thanks. See y'all next week.
Again, thank y'all so much for joining us, man. We so appreciate it. Make sure you tune in next week. August the 15th, listen, tune in, because we're going to be celebrating 1 year anniversary and also my birthday. God bless y'all. We love y'all. Y'all be blessed. Peace. I just so many losses. Could have lost it.